could always be some trouble.
Oh, absolutely. And the Sheik is in the ring with his man. Let's go for the introductions to Larry Nelson.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is one ball. There is a 15-minute time limit. First of all, accompanied to the ring by his manager, Sheik Adnan El Kaissey. He weighs in at 270 pounds. He is from Siberia, Russia. He is Boris, Zhukov. His opponent is from Edina, Minnesota. Weighing in at 235 pounds, Steve Olsonoski.
Thank you very much, Larry Nelson. Well, Boris Zhukov is one of the really, really giants in the AWA at over 300 pounds. One of the Sheik's army, the Sheik, of course, being Sheik Adnan El Kaissey. USA, USA. Now the referee checking over Boris Zhukov. Make sure that he has no foreign objects in the knee pads or in the boots. Actually, Dick Jankowski, I think that he should check over Sheik Adnan El Kaissey as well, because he can conceal foreign objects in his garb much more easily than his man Zhukov can. And of course, he has been known to do things along this particular line.
As we all know that, anybody who's followed the AWA for any length of time certainly realizes you've got to watch him.
Okay, we're underway with Zhukov and Steve Olsonoski. Zhukov, of course, has maintained for a long, long time that he should have a shot at heavyweight championship. Dick Clark, and he indeed would win that championship. And then, of course, Sheik Adnan El Kaissey says it's just a matter of course they're going back to back and rock with that championship belt. Well, we will have to see what we will have to see about that. As Zhukov and Sheik Adnan El Kaissey are outside the ring. Why so early, I don't know, but...
Rod, we talk about great athletes, and it seems like all wrestlers have played one or two or three or four more, you know, sports as far as high school or college. Olsonoski, also a good football player in high school at Edina.
Let's go, Boris, let's go!
And comes from a great football family. His father, Larry Olsonoski, was a football great at the University of Minnesota. Along about the same time that Vern Gagne was not only a great wrestling champion at the University of Minnesota, but was also an outstanding football player in the Bernie Bierman era at the U of M of the Golden Gophers.
Absolutely. Back to, in fact, 1949, when you look back at those great teams, Vern, of course, was there along with Bud Grant and those others. Clay Tonemaker, great ball clubs, that's right.
Promoter out in the Oakland, California area. Oh, there were some great, great football teams. There's no two ways about that.
Leo, of course, familiar, I'm sure, to a lot of the fans in this area. He's been in several times as a troubleshooting referee for the AWA.
Side headlock here for Steve Olsonoski. Steve-o. Oh, hard shoulder block, Olsonoski. Zhukov felt that one, I can guarantee you. Oh, side headlock and a hip toss, and down they go. Those were some quick, jarring move by Steve Olsonoski on Boris Zhukov.
Steve, grab his wig.
Christmas night, and of course, talking to some youngsters prior to the matches, some of them had the little AWA dolls that they received as Christmas gifts, and you know, there's about 30 of those out now.
Absolutely. side headlock, then grabs a hold of that piece of hair that Zhukov has, and that's all the hair he has on his head. And almost did Zhukov's head reach the ring post? If not, it came very, very close.
It looked like he might have just nicked it, might have just tipped that ring post.
He's over, of course, on the opposite side of the ring from us. We can't see if he is cut or not. It does not look like it. Steve Olsonoski hammers away to the head. Irish whip up and almost over and out, just about into our lap. Back to the side. Steve Olsonoski. Zhukov picks him up. Down they go. Olsonoski maintains that side headlock. Gets a two count.
Olsonoski asking for a faster count. And some of the fans also, as you might hear in the background.
Steve-O maintaining that side headlock on Boris Zhukov. Oh, what great wrestling action we have for you coming up. The six-man tag is next, that being Greg Gagne, Leon White, Scott Hall on one side. What a combination. That Leon White, full power against Larry Zbysko, the living legend. Oh, watch the action. Hard shoulder block by Zbysko. The action fast and furious. Across they go. Up and down. Steve Olsonoski, and now missing the elbow smash is Zhukov. Side headlock again by Steve Olsonoski. We were saying about the six-man tag that is up and coming. Larry Zbysko, the legend, as he likes to call himself, along with Super Ninja, who may, he certainly will, if he ever gets the opportunity, put on what he calls the Super Ninja Suplex and Bridge. Wow, nobody does it better, or more authentic, or more powerfully, I'm sure, than does the Super Ninja. And then Mr. Silent, who is back in action. Furious over what's been going on in his life the past year and a half. Just waiting for this particular night when he is back in action. And tonight it is. And we will see Mr. Saidu, who has maintained tremendous physical condition over the past year and a half when he has been away. So that's just ahead.
Absolutely, Rod. And I was just thinking, when you talk about Super Ninja, as you know, normally doing the ring announcing for the AWA, Super Ninja has great feet, as he showed me a couple of in the October card here at St. Paul Civic Center. After being eliminated from the Battle Royal, he kicked the microphone out of my hand from about 3 feet away.
Uh-huh.
Terrific. Very agile.
He is quite an athlete. There's no two ways about it. Master of the martial arts. He himself may indeed. Anyway, championship. And I would guess that Nick Bockwinkel, or whoever the heavyweight champion will be after tonight, will have to contend with the likes of the Super Ninja as a challenger somewhere down the line. Wristlock here by Steve-O on Boris Zhukov. Zhukov turns it around and powers Steve-O back through the canvas. This is one fall, 20 minutes. Good close up there of Boris Zhukov. Zhukov bouncing his foot off the arm of Steve-O, who got a couple of boots up into the face of Zhukov for the moment. Now he's got Olsonoski's left arm wrapped around the top rope strand and trying to wrap it around again, and it just doesn't manage to go that way. Hard headbutt to the shoulder, to the deltoid muscle area of Steve Olsonoski. That man, Boris Zhukov, is like a brick. Olsonoski rolling out, not only out of the way, but out of the ring. Wanting to buy some time and get the circulation back in that front shoulder. As you look at it, along with us, so now we switch on to the center of the ring and Boris Zhukov.
You mentioned the camera work a little earlier. I have to second that. Of course, One of our favorites, Mike Shields, always does an excellent job. As far as the doctor's concerned, terrific shot. Olsonoski getting some fans behind him here at ringside.
And of course, the ball on the side of Steve Olsonoski. Certainly not on the side of Boris Zhukov.
Come on, Steve
comes up to
the
Zhukov goes back to work again on the arm.
Hook him in the arm.
Come on. Steve-O. Move around a little bit. Don't play dead now. Yeah, lose.
Shut up.
Here we are right there. Come on, Zhukov. Come on. Zhukov. You're good.
Take a look at him.
Referee forces you to break the hold.
Don't you feed that boy!
Steve Olsonoski backs up. Delivers a hard right hand. And then gets a sledgehammer right across the back. To the axilla with a hard shot. Boris Zhukov again to the axilla of Steve Olsonoski.
They have about 9 minutes gone this far in this match, as you might think. 20 minutes.
No! No!
Steve Olsonoski. Not on the greatest of kickball here and now.
No. Push him into the pole! Push him into the pole! Let's go! Come on! Go! Into the pole!
That brings on your hand. You can certainly tell whose side he's on. Watch Steve Olsonoski to get back in this and take control.
Break it out! Break it out! Break it out! Break it! Break it!
Zhukov. Few minutes, and Zhukov, knowing that he has his hand in trouble, goes right back to work on it, as any great wrestler should. He's got his man hurt. Go to the area that's hurting and make some more. And that's exactly what he's doing. Olsonoski charges into that corner, and the left shoulder pays the price. Don't know how much more of this Steve Olsonoski can handle without being turned into a one-armed wrestler. That left
hand. Break it on. Break it on. Let him give up. Let him give up.
No.
Give up.
No.
Shut up. Sit down, Daniel. You're looking big, you.
Sheik Adnan El Kaissey never, never at a loss for words. And keep your eye on him. He may well indeed be involved in the outcome of this match. Some form of interference from outside of that ring. A nice kick out there by Steve Olsonoski. Here comes Boris Zhukov. And Steve-O backs off just two steps and is able to get that leg up and takes it into the midsection, takes a hard smash, and then comes off the ropes and a forearm smash by Steve-O. And down goes Zhukov. Steve Olsonoski is on the attack. First with a right hand, and then a judo shot, and then an Irish whip across, and a big back body drop. Steve Olsonoski suddenly with things going his way. And a drop kick as he caught Boris Zhukov flush in the face. A quick cover, count of one and two, and Zhukov gets that right leg draped over that lower rope swing.
That was as fine a drop kick as you'll see, just exactly the way it should be done. Beautiful.
Atomic drop there. A cover again by Olsonoski. hooks the leg, gets a two count, but not three, as again, that left leg is draped over the lower left strand. Boris Zhukov taking a lot of punishment from the Edina, Minnesota native. There's a hard body slam. Here goes Steve-O. And here he comes, but he misses the elbow smash. Takes one from Zhukov. Cover by Zhukov. Count of one, two, and three. There was a leg break over that lower rope strand, but apparently it did not get there in time. The referee gave it the three count. One, two, three. And Boris Zhukov is your winner here over Steve Olsonoski out of Edina, Minnesota. And what was the time on that?
Right, the match, 13 minutes and 9 seconds, 13:09.
The referee says it was a three count, a solid three count before Olsonoski got that leg draped over the lower rope strand, and so it is, a W for Boris Zhukov as we head to ringside now, and Larry Nelson.
Well, I don't know if it means much to you, but Merry Christmas, Sheik Adnan El Kaissey. Well, I don't celebrate Christmas, you know that? Most of the people don't celebrate Christmas. Now let's get down to business. We are challenging the winner of Big Buck will call in for a title match for the heavyweight champion of the world, and we don't care who the winner is going to be.
I come out here
to challenge the winner of this match for the heavyweight championship belt, because he's ready, and you saw him right here in the ring, defeated that busted man, Steve Olsonoski. Tavares Risky Nerani. Anytime, winner match, contending or Nick Buckwinkle, and one challenge. You understand? And it's I wish you Merry Christmas to Steve-O. To Zhukov, it is a joke. We do not care about Christmas in our country. How can a country celebrate Christmas and send arms to Iran to fight my comrade? This is not fair.
Ladies and gentlemen, I will reiterate, we are live Christmas night at the Civic Center in St. Paul, the Brawl in St. Paul. You know there's a long line of people that want to challenge the winner of this championship match. It's coming up
all the time, but my man has been improving. All the time he's been with his matches. Nick Buckwinkle could have a match tonight. The winner would put the belt against my comrade, and I don't care what the AEW have to say. Do you understand? It's because yes, the money's against us. They have no choice but to give us a title match. And no matter, Nick Buckwinkle or contending, I want the title shot. I want it now.
How about that Jimmy Snuka and Greg Garnier?
And they're going to be really Jimmy Snuka tonight for good.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going now back to Rod Trongard and Dick Jonkowski.
Thank you very much, Larry Nelson. And again, Merry Christmas, everyone. And we're glad to have you aboard here from the St. Paul Civic Center. And All-Star Wrestling here this Christmas Day night. And Dick Jonkowski, we hope it was a great, great Christmas for you.
Well, Rodney, not bad at all. As always, I got a little